I'm rocking right now Mojo. You know, shout out to Mojo. YouTube girl got a chance to interview her, so we're going to have a lot of footage and things about that. But shout out to Mojo. She was phenomenal. And shout out to the people that she promotes and what she's doing in Columbus as well. But anyway, YouTube girl, I'd like to congratulate her on her debut today. You're going to be seeing a lot of YouTube girl. We're going to have interviews. We're going to be interviewing people. We're going to have various talk shows. We're going to have her talking about current events, things like, for instance, did you know that the United States basketball, men's basketball team won the gold today? Well, that's something that's current right there. You know, the shout out to USA, men's basketball team. They won the gold medal today. And we're going to just be talking about various things like that. But anyway, it's late. YouTube girl, she's been getting in all day long, you know. I'm really proud of her, and I want to say congratulations to keep up the good work. Look out for Rawson Originals, YouTube girl, the one and only right here. We're original YouTube girl. If there's any other person saying that they're YouTube girl, don't believe the hype. This is the original YouTube girl right here. Rawson Originals, YouTube girl, and action.
Hi, I'm being interviewing with
Mojo, Team Mojo Promotion, Columbus, Ohio.
How did you get started on promoting?
I started a couple years ago as an artist, and I just went from there, and I kind of started working with the artist and talent I took to back.
Really? You were an artist?
Yeah.
What did you say?
I did like R&B, hip-hop, freestyle.
Well,
that's what I mean that I took it to the backseat, is because I realized that the artists shine more and my shine is in promotion. So I shine through helping them shine. And we go to other cities, come home.
So that's what's got you promoting. Are you happy with promoting? Do you love promoting?
I love promoting. I do fashion, hip hop, hip soul, jazz, cubicle.
What would you say your favorite
The music. Anything music, yeah.
So, what would you say your favorite genre to promote it? Or what you listen to in your car?
Hip-hop.
Hip-hop?
Yeah. And I don't even listen to, like, radio stuff because I'm so local. I want to take people out of their local areas and branch out.
How do you find people
here? It's like the domino effect. It started one day, one artist, word of mouth, good business, and it really reaches us.
Sources to find you local artists, or do you personally get in touch with them to find
you? Well, I do personally call or assist, but they can go to teammojo.com and find my website there.
So how'd you get your business?
That is quite how my business started. I was an artist one day on stage, and I said, you know what? I think that I'm just gonna go ahead and take a step back.
Are you like individual, or do you have groups, or you're just?
Well, Team Mojo is just myself, so the whole team is just, I move like a team, but it's really just one person. I say a good percentage of the talent I do work with in Columbus. I mean, I have a good fan base follow.
So you're pretty known. How do you promote yourself to get as far as you
want? My website, Twitter, any social network, street soldiers, you move, pass out flyers, things like that.
That's pretty interesting. I love the fact that you promote, because it seems like you're a very good businesswoman for what you do.
Thank you.
And I would like to know how you go about your business. What is your personal maintenance for you to deal with as an artist, and when you're promoting, the rules you put down?
The rules I put down for them is to come in, get heard, network and promote yourself, and help me help you. That's my expectations. And
are there any have as in what they do in their personal lives, so it won't affect?
Absolutely. I'm sorry to cut you off, but the thing is I'm known for the positive movement. I'm all about unity, and a lot of people have the wrong idea about hip-hop and rap and stuff like that. No, I try to turn things around, show them it's not always like that. Because our youth of today, I do a lot of youth stuff too, our youth of today, they're not understanding real music anymore. So I like to bring that back in, get positive, allow their parents to allow their kids to listen.
Is what you do like every day, like every minute of your life, daily basis? Do you ever get any breaks if you're promoting?
No, and it's because you're always networking. It falls into that. You're networking when you're not working, when you think you're not working. Okay, seriously. Like, some things that I've done recently, I took, I think, 36, 37 artists to the Ohio State Fair. They have never had, like, hip-hop locally. In history, so I love that. And that's me networking, promoting, right?
Yeah.
I'm sick. I'm always on it.
That sounds like fun. I might promote one day. I'm thinking about it.
I see your girl.
Yeah, I'm listening. I'm like, let me ask these questions so I can figure out what I want to do.
Like, hold on. I see this little lady doing this. Let me go ahead and get the guidelines.
Yeah, because, like, I don't know. I'm glad you took back your career and helped others with things.
Mm-hmm.
So, honestly, in my opinion, powerful than just you shining by yourself, just helping others.
Yeah,
so,
I appreciate that.
Yeah.
I love it. Absolutely.
Want to give any shout outs?
Yeah, I just want to say thank you, Columbus, Ohio. Thank you, Youngstown, for having me. Nia Green, Franklin County Boys, 4020 Boys. Thank you. Thank you, too.